marriage, harmony of body and soul. You are both body and light or soul or noor or ruh. Body is visible, soul in the gross form, and soul is invisible body in the subtle form. They are part of one harmony. They are part of one whole. You have to accept your body. You have to love it, respect it, because it is the temple. Body is the most complex mechanism in the existence. It is simply marvelous. You have to begin with a feeling of awe and respect for the body and wonder with your body and its mechanism. Body is closest to you. You know this. This you can feel and touch as well. So begin with that which is closer to you. That's where the journey begins. Through the body, existence has come closer to you. Your body contains the sense organs, the waters of the oceans, fire of the stars and the sun. As the life force, air constitutes your body. Your body is made of earth. It is humus. It is a connection between the gross and the subtle. When the subtle elements come to manifest at the gross level, body is formed. Body represents all the elements of which existence is composed of. What a transformation, what a metamorphosis. Look at the earth and now look at your body. What a transformation, and you have never marveled. Dust has become divine. What greater mystery can there be? What greater miracle can there be? This you cannot envision. You are only interested in pretty miracles. Each finite moment existence happens as a miracle. A speck of dust becomes divine as your body. Out of mud blossoms the divine beauty as a flower. A dewdrop slips from the lotus leaf to dissolve in the lake. Out of the mud has evolved the beautiful lotus and your body. This is the miracle of the unknown. Be open to this. Open your eyes to witness this. A new vision awaits thee. Your body is your greatest friend. Take care of the body in the form of nourishment. All the sense organs through which you experience the world of duality exist in the body. It is giving you the right indication. The body is very wise. Mind is a later development. Body has lived millions of years. It knows what is needed. It is the mind that interferes. Mind is very immature, but body is very mature. Listen to the body. And when I say listen to the body, I do not ask you to remain confined to it. If you listen to your body, the body will not have anything to say to you, but things will be settled. And when the body is at ease, relaxed, there is no tension, and the body is not fighting something or trying to attract your attention because you are not fulfilling a need. When the body is calm and quiet, you can fly high, you can become a white cloud. But this happens only when the body needs are truly looked after. The body is not your enemy, instead it is your friend. It is your earth that has all the roots hidden within its womb. All the sense organs are there. And through the sense organs, you interact in the world of objects and beings. You have to find a bridge between you and your body. If you do not find that bridge, you will be constantly in conflict with your body. A person who is fighting with himself is always miserable. The first thing is to come to a peace pact with your body and never break it. Once you have come to this pact with your body, body will become very friendly. You will look after the body and body will look after for you. In the process, it becomes a vehicle of tremendous value. It becomes a very temple, and then one day your body itself is revealed to you as the very shrine of God. I had mentioned to you how does the sense organs function when they interact in the world of objects and beings. And a beautiful sutras are there in Bhagavad Gita. Dhyayato Vishyanapunsa Sangasteshu Pajayate Sangat Sanjayate Kama Kamat Krodo Vijayate Krodat Bhavati Sammoha Sammohat Smriti Vibhrama Smriti Branshad Buddhinasho Buddhinashad Pranashyati. When you constantly dwell in the sense objects, that normally happens. Because we have sense objects, we have sense organs within us, and we are dwelling in the world that is filled with sense objects of many kinds. You are constantly looking at a certain object, a certain person, again and again, you develop an attachment. Someone tells you about an object, you constantly contemplate, you happen to see a person, you begin to contemplate upon the beauty and the person, attachment is formed. And from attachment, myriad desires come. Desires are innumerable in nature and can never be fulfilled. That is the nature of the desire. You fulfill one, another arises and they go on mushrooming. And when desires remain unfulfilled, because not all desires one can fulfill, mind and the sense organs together, they weave a web around you that you want to get this, that and everything, but all the things are not within your means. Desires remain unfulfilled. One has to be rational about the desires. And unfulfilled desires brings anger. So when you are constantly contemplating on the sense organs and sense objects and their functioning, first desire for lust, attachment arises, and unfulfilled desires, myriad desires are born. Unfulfilled desires give rise to anger. And with anger, delusion arises, your intellect, your reasoning becomes deluded. And when it becomes deluded, your memory becomes confused. You forget that you are here for a specific purpose. In the beginning of the creation, God hid himself and manifested you. Now it is you, through your presence, you have to manifest that which is you. Forget this. The memory is beclouded. And from the confusion of the memory, there is loss of reason. And when there is a loss of reason, the process of ruin begins. Process of destruction begins. On the contrary, if there is awareness, and you with the awareness comes self-control. One who is self-controlled, one who is aware, while interacting in the world of objects and beings, And while enjoying various sense objects through his senses, it includes both animate and inanimate. Marriage is an aspect of male-female relation where you interact with one another through the sense organs. When you interact in a disciplined manner with awakening, you are freed from likes and dislikes, and placidity of the mind comes. Mind becomes tranquil. Desires get satiated. You know all desires cannot be satiated, but through awareness, through understanding, satiation begins to come. And when the mind attains to placidity, all sorrows, anxiety comes to an end. The intellect of such a person becomes tranquil and begins to withdraw itself from all sides and finally gets established in his own being, or what we call God. On the contrary, who has not developed awareness, who has not controlled his mind and senses, will not have any discrimination how to interact in the world of objects and being. Your mind becomes like a child. You see something, the child wants that. The moment child gets that, and his mind, he sees something else, he cries for that. And this process continues. He forgets that he has already have. Instead, he begins to have, begins to ask for something else. This is the nature of the human mind. You have a spouse, you see someone else, you desire that. There is no discrimination, there is no awareness, nor there is contemplation. Without this awareness, without contemplation, there will be no peace of mind. And when the peace of mind is not there, the bliss or happiness will not be there. And your mind will be like a wind that takes away the boat that is sailing on the water, and there is a strong wind. Strong wind deviates the boat from its path and it soars. It may drown even. When the sense organs begin to move amidst the sense objects and beings, one whose mind is attached, who has not developed awareness, is deviated and he moves away from his path. Those whose senses are completely restrained from the functioning of the sense organs and objects are stable in mind. This is the process. That is why body is the beginning. But body is given to you to experience that which is subtle in you. When you have food in front of you, there is a physical form of the food and there is an intrinsic or the subtle form of the food which you cannot see. Your focus should be on the subtle aspect, the nutritional aspect of the food that gives you the nourishment. In each interaction between the sense organs and the objects, sense objects and beings, there is a gross aspect and there is a subtle aspect. Subtle aspect will continue your inward journey and take you to the, and the journey of transcendence will begin. If you want to be, now you have to find the bridge between these two aspects, the visible and invisible, between you and your body. If you do not find that bridge, you will be constantly in conflict with your body, the sense objects, the sense organs, And a person who is fighting with himself is always miserable. So the first thing is to come to a peace pact with your body and never break it. Allow awareness to be there as the guiding force. And then you will realize that your body has become the temple, and one day your body itself is revealed to you as the shrine of the God. If you really want to be a sensitive, intelligent mind, you need a sensitive, intelligent body as well. Yes, body has its own intelligence. Look at a small child, an infant. You put all kinds of food in front of the child. The intellect, the understanding, like that of an adult, is not developed into the child. Child will pick up that food which is beneficial for his health. Psychologists have discovered this. This is the intelligence of the body. Body gives you the indication. Body has its own intelligence, but we have lost the capacity to discern that. Therefore, do not kill it or destroy it. Otherwise, you will be destroying your intelligence. But if it is respected, then it becomes something religious, spiritual, and holy as well. In the beginning, it will be difficult. But for just 3 weeks, allow nature to function. When you feel hungry, eat. And when you feel sleepy, go to sleep. It does not matter what time it is. When you do not feel hungry, there is no need to eat. And when the food is there in front of you, some things may be that you may like very much. So you would like to overeat that. No. There has to be a moderation in that. And this is not fast. Remember, because a fast is from the mind, and you are feeling hungry, but you are on the fast. You are supposed to fast during a certain period of time, so you cannot eat. Fast is a mental control of the body. And I am speaking to use the intelligence of the body. It does not allow the body its natural intelligence. Fasts are done to discipline the body of its habits. But no fast is for the discipline of the mind. There is no harm if you do not feel sleepy. There is no harm because body does not need it. So do not force it. Stay awake. Enjoy. Go for a walk. Have a little dance in the room. Or sing or meditate. But do not force sleep, because sleep is not something that can be forced. It comes when it comes. When you feel sleepy, when the eye says, now go to sleep, then do not force the body to remain awake. This way you will be destroying the natural rhythm of the body. And do not force yourself in the morning to come out of the bed. Instead, allow your inner being, give it a chance. The body will indicate and the eyes will open by themselves. For a few days there will be difficulty. But within 3 weeks, miracle will happen. And I say within 3 weeks, but you do not interfere the natural rhythm. If you interfere, then even 3 lives are not enough. Therefore, never interfere and just wait for things to happen. Allow them. Within 3 weeks, you will fall into a natural rhythm once again. A new process will begin. Torturing is not the way. By torturing yourself, you can meditate easily. On the contrary, if your body is unpleasantly at ease, you can meditate even more easily. If your body is pleasantly at ease, you can meditate even more easily. I do not think that when you are fasting, you can meditate. You can only think of food and nothing else. You will dream of food and constantly think what to eat now and what to prepare for the next meal and nothing else. But if you are well fed, well nourished, you will not think of food as there is no need. This also applies to the physical needs, needs of the male-female relation, needs of at the level of sex. The body is fully satiated and now it does not create any disturbance. To live pleasurably and joyfully is not against meditation. It is really the basic need of meditation. There are many ascetics, but I have never seen any trace of intelligence in them. I have never seen any creativity in them, and also I have not seen in their eyes a light of the beyond, or in their gestures a message, a reflex that can be said not of this world. They do not have anything like that. They are simply starving and go on starving because it fulfills the ego. Because the more they starve, the more torture themselves, more and more people come to worship them. People can be helped with disease because almost 70% of diseases are mental. They may be expressed through the body, but their origin is in the mind. If you can put in the mind the idea that disease has disappeared, that you need not worry about it. It does not exist anymore. The disease will disappear. Fighting with the body is not the way. The most important thing is understanding it, going into awareness. Let there be security watch of the awareness, of mindfulness. Whatever you do, you understand the nature of the sense objects, sense organs, the objects and beings move, then it would be easier for you. And when this begins to happen, you begin to move in a totally different dimension. You must know that energy is always released. So you have to be aware how this energy is released. There are different postures when you are sitting down in meditation that I will take on another time. But here, what is important, that let the natural rhythm of the body be established. Only then the body, one day you will realize the body is the temple, and through the body you will experience that which is invisible. The invisible will begin to manifest through the visible, and that is the entire process of spiritual life or meditation or whatever we call. Let the light manifest through your each act, each thought, and each action, all that you do while living in the world of objects and beings. You are in the world then, but the world and its dualities are not in you. Beyond the duality, you seek bliss, you seek harmony, you seek the placidity of the mind.